In tonight's Dateline news, Rockford city workers threaten to strike. A charge reduction for a convicted arsonist. A Rockford house is gutted by fire. And part two of Nuclear Medicine and You. All next.
A special winter purchase allows us to offer quality name summer furniture at savings up to 30% while they last at House of Lindberg.
WREX-TV, Rockford, Illinois.
I'm Linda Schaefer.
And I'm Jeff McAtee. The man accused of starting the Janesville apartment fire last August that killed three people has had his charge reduced. Russell Dibble had been charged with one count of arson and three counts of second-degree murder. In a plea bargain arrangement with a Rock County District Attorney, Dibble today pleaded guilty to one charge of second-degree murder. The other three charges were dropped. Dibble will be sentenced March 4th. Although the arson charge will not be part of his conviction, the judge will be asked to bear it in mind when he decides the sentence. Today, an empty house on Rockford's northwest side was gutted by late fire. Fire officials blame the fire on a faulty furnace. According to neighbors, the home had been deserted for over a month and was a virtual playground for local children. No one was injured in the fire, and there isn't any damage estimate available at this time.
Winnebago County Supervisor of Assessments Ben Jenness has reacted to reports that some board members may again be trying to oust him from his position. They're reportedly trying to lock Jenness out of his office. The matter is expected to be presented first to the Finance and Taxation Committee Wednesday night and to the full board on Thursday. Jenness says he's received no official notice of the action and claims the matter is politically motivated.
It has to be completely politically motivated, and it's popular to jump on the supervisor of assessments if you want to be reelected again, and saying that you're against what he's doing and that sort of thing. But if the facts were known, all the accusations that I described earlier as vague are very vague, and nobody has made a specific accusation where this office has failed to do its duty in any way.
The board has in the past asked for Jenness's resignation and last year voted to cut his salary by $8,000. The board cannot legally fire Jenness unless they prove malfeasance. Jenness says he's doing the job and claims the board has brought no specific charges against him. County board member Millie Zimmerman agrees that there may have been problems with the job in the past, but she doesn't think locking Jenness out of his office is the solution. She also feels the action may have been timed when county board chairman Larry Ralston was out of town and would not be presiding over the board. Ralston has supported Jenness in the past. Some old emotions are being raised from the past, along with the resurrection of draft registration. Nancy Helmick has that story.
Protest isn't new to the campus of Northern Illinois University. The music is the same, the cause is the same, but it's not 1967, it's 1980, and the protesters are marching again.
To refuse to cooperate ain't no dancing.
Most of the 200 people outside Holmes Student Center were opposed to draft registration. They told me, as far as they were concerned, the nationwide sign-up was the first step to something more serious.
I mean, if people start registering, he has people at his fingertips to call them in for the draft, and he's more likely to start a war through that.
There's a paranoia in the United States government with the Brzezinski-Carter people that is incredible. You know, the overreaction to the Afghan situation has been very intense, and I just don't think that if we have a registration, there will not be a draft.
But not everyone was in agreement. Some students felt this time the United States had a reason to stand up and fight.
Peace first, always peace. But when a country knows that you're just going to sit by and take abuse and take abuse. Well, they're going to just dish it out as much as they can. And America's been stepped on too long.
So each side argued its point, and nobody really convinced anybody else. The thing they could agree on is that there is something wrong and something needs to be done. From DeKalb, Nancy Helmick, Dateline 13 News.
Rockford City workers are threatening to go on strike if a new contract isn't worked out soon. Tonight, the workers are calling for a strike vote to allow their union to walk out when they feel they must sometime in the future. But Mayor McGaw says he's not worried about a strike. It's just a routine threat, he says, to get a better contract offer.
We've made a reasonable offer, and they've come back with their final reasonable offer, and we're not that far apart, and I don't think a strike will materialize. I think we'll be able to hammer it out.
McGaw says he has no idea when a contract settlement will be worked out. Will the Rockford City Council vote to build more parking decks, or will they just decide to create more ground-level parking lots? That decision and more from Dateline 13 City Hall reporter Ron Shearer.
The council must decide is whether it wants to demolish buildings and replace them with parking lots or build parking decks like this one. It's a matter of aesthetics versus cost. The council will also look at whether to build a metro transit center and overhead pedestrian walkways that would link buildings like the county courthouse to the Talcott building. Another vote is planned tonight on whether the city will allow $10 million in industrial revenue bonds to build a hotel complex in the county. Some aldermen believe the city shouldn't allow the bonds to be passed unless the hotel and its nearby properties become annexed into the city. But because most aldermen believe annexation is inevitable, the bond should be passed without much discussion. Ron Shearer, Dateline 13 News.
One other idea the city council will toss around tonight is whether it wants to allow sidewalk peddlers on the streets. Now, last week, the council voted for a similar proposal, but since that time, Metro Center manager Doug Logan has been lobbying the aldermen to vote the ordinance down. Logan says that allowing the vendors on the sidewalks would present a crowd control problem near the Metro Center events and would also crimp concession sales in the center. The Metro Center gets a percentage of all products sold in its arena.
A 21-year-old Amboy motorist faces charges in connection with that weekend traffic accident that fatally injured four elderly women in Sterling on Saturday. Police tell El Cio Carmona ran a stoplight. His car hit the woman's auto broadside. Carmona has been charged with reckless homicide, driving while intoxicated, reckless driving, and disobeying a stoplight. He had been hospitalized with injuries but was shifted to the Whiteside County Jail today. The Stars and Stripes will fly in front of the Rock River Valley Council of Girl Scouts main office building from now on. Today, an American flag was given to the council as a gift from the Henstead chapter of the Daughters of American Colonists. The colonists want to promote patriotic education in Illinois, and they want to be sure all scout troops have flags. Therefore, two troops in the area will be given flags this week. It's coincidental that today's ceremony fell on Abraham Lincoln's birthday, which is today. And Marlon tells me that there has been a shift and we may have some snow this week.
We may get some snow, but it's going to warm up. Appropriately enough, it was 12 below zero on the 12th of February, you know, for Abraham Lincoln's birthday, which isn't a record. It tied the record. Very cold indeed, but it's going to warm up and we're going to get some snow.
Sounds good to me. Details in just a moment.
When I buy auto insurance, I want quality protection at a reasonable price.
Think economy.
And if I have a claim, I want to know I'll get fast, fair service.
Think economy.
And where our home is concerned,
we want wall-to-wall protection.
Then think economy. Contact one of the fine agents representing Economy Fire and Casualty, shown here.
We've got something to smile about, and we want to share it with you. The National Weight Control Clinic program has worked for thousands of others, and we can help you lose weight, too.
And now you can take advantage of National's 10% special coupon discount. Call today, won't you?
You'll be smiling while you're losing the National Weight Control Clinic's way.
Call today and smile. Call 964-3740. That's 964-3740.
I don't know why it's always the coldest that part of the day, right when everybody has to go to work, but that's the way it was. This high-pressure system, which was right over northeastern Oklahoma, brought very clear skies and very cold temperatures over the center portion of the country, down to 12 below zero this morning in Rockford, tied the record set back in 1917 of 12 below. 28 for a high today in St. Louis, and 25 in Milwaukee highs over the afternoon hours. 46 in Atlanta, mostly clear skies east of the Mississippi River, and if you're keeping track, we have about 3 inches of snow on the ground here, and they have about 3.5 inches of snow at Lake Placid. So we're waiting for the storm to come, and once the storm gets here, well, we just might beat Lake Placid as far as snow cover is concerned. They're making snow there now, and so most of their alpine events should be in good shape. 36 in New York City today, 70 down in Miami with clear skies. In Dallas, Texas, 53 and partly cloudy, but a little rain activity going on along the Texas coast, anywhere from Brownsville, Texas, where they picked up a third of an inch, to Corpus Christi, Texas, where they picked up a third of an inch. Alice, Texas beat both of them. She had around 2/3 of an inch of rain. That's an Dallas, Texas. Another high-pressure system right now in southern Colorado, bringing them fair skies, but those fair skies start to deteriorate because of that storm system right now in southwestern North Dakota, causing snowfall from portions of Wyoming back through Montana, where they have traveler's advisories issued because they expect anywhere from 1 to 3 inches of snow and a little blowing and drifting with that. Some low cloudiness from Idaho back through Oregon and Washington, partly cloudy today in Seattle with a high of around 43 degrees, and fair skies in Los Angeles with a high of around 68 degrees. Right now in the state line area, we have a current temperature reading of 15 degrees. Our high this afternoon, 20 degrees. Low this morning, that tied the record, 12 below zero. And I won't mention it again. Humidity right now at 64%. Barometer stands at 30.20 and holding steady. And the wind is out of the southwest at 18 miles an hour, which our cameraman Jim Jackson pointed out, gives us a wind chill factor of 15 degrees below zero. So it's kind of uncomfortable if you don't go out and wrap yourself up. Mostly sunny skies in the state line area as it sets in the west. Temperatures around the area look like this. 17 in Milwaukee, 13 in Madison, 20 in Chicago, also 20 in Peoria and Springfield. 27 the warmest right now in St. Louis. Sun came up this morning at 6:57 when it was very, very cold, and set this afternoon at 5:25, just a little while ago. Not too bad. We'll be back with a look at the forecast. That's not too bad either, right after this.
Great news from the optical department at Sears. Soft contact lenses at the low price of only $99. For me, so comfortable and easy to care for. We've satisfied thousands of people with soft contacts. Probably some of your friends. Imagine, soft contact lenses for only $99. Lens care kit, $10 additional. Come and see us today.
The optical department at Sears.
We have just about over 2 hours before the start of the televised coverage of the Olympics, and in consideration of that, tonight's weather picture sent in by Tim Robert Rao from Moscow, Illinois, who goes to Rockton Grade School, and his teacher is Mrs. Applegate, and it's a very nice weather picture. You like skiing? This is the channel to watch for the next week or so. Very nice weather picture and very nice skiing weather. Partly cloudy tonight with a low of around 5 degrees. Tomorrow, cloudy with an increasing chance of snow. Let's call it 40% chance by tomorrow afternoon. High tomorrow afternoon around 25 degrees. Low tomorrow night, 7 degrees above zero with another 40% chance of snow. And then looking ahead for Thursday, mostly sunny and a high of around 25 degrees. So temperatures are going to stay right about, we're running about 5 to 6 degrees below the norm, but we're going to get snow. You like snow, it's okay.
Yeah, I kind of like snow. Skiing planned.
Is that the kind of figure you cut when you're going downhill?
Yes, yes, most definitely. Usually the mountains are a little bit steeper, but similar, of course. Thanks, Marlon. Okay, we'll have part two in the series on nuclear medicine in just a moment.
It's that time of day when you can say, come on and head for the mountains. The taste is smooth and waiting for you.
Here's to a beer brewed slow, cold, and natural for a taste as smooth as its name.
Bush. Head for Bush Beer.
At Bloomquist's, you can always choose from over 250 sofas, sectionals, love seats, and sleep sofas. Famous name lines offer the finest selection of quality at the lowest possible prices.
An interim nuclear fuel storage facility may soon be built in northeastern Illinois. President Carter announced today that Morris, Illinois is one of the three possible sites in the nation where a storage facility could be located. Government officials say Morris is a prime location to store spent nuclear fuel since a storage site is already located there. Nuclear medicine today is used for a variety of tests called scans. Through them, doctors can examine the lungs, liver, brain, and more. Tonight in part two in the series Nuclear Medicine and You, we take an in-depth look at the scans.
Nuclear medicine is being used frequently and successfully and outweighs older methods.
We had to rely on x-ray pictures of the bones, and they often failed to detect the abnormality until it was too far advanced for successful treatment. The isotope will localize in a lesion that we can't see by x-ray and will show it up even before the patient has pain in the area. So the treatment can be started in advance and is therefore has a better chance of succeeding.
Basically, scans are taken by a camera receiving electrical impulses from the body. You're able to see the impulses on an oscilloscope, like a monitor. Then, looking at the results of a scan, dark spots will show up called hot spots. That's where radioactivity would collect. Here's an explanation of two bone scans.
This one on the right here is normal. The one on the left is distinctly abnormal. This is a typical metastatic disease to the bone from a cancer. And the cancers that usually go to bone like this are lung cancer and breast cancer. Those are the two big ones that we think of. And this one, you can see each one of the individual vertebrae down the spine. They're all fairly uniform density. You can see each one of the ribs. This little hot spot here is from the tip of the clavicle, and that's a normal finding. The skull is normal. The pelvis bones are normal. This hot spot you see here is the urinary bladder because the isotope's being excreted by the kidneys and is slowly concentrating in the bladder. This area here is where the injection of the isotope, some of it leaked out of the vein and continues to sit in the soft tissues. And you can see here in the diseased patient that there's a lot of hot spots down through the spine. Now, this one here and this one here, these two hot spots are actually the kidney, which is concentrating the isotope, getting rid of it, and this is the urinary bladder. You can tell that this is a man because the prostate is indenting the floor of the urinary bladder. Now, there's a hot spot here, which is in the pelvic bone. If you look over here, there are hot spots down near the pelvic bone, which are the sacroiliac joints. But out here where this area is here, this is a definitely abnormal hot spot sitting out in the iliac bone. When we see this many hot spots, and especially concentrated in the center of the body, down the spine and in the pelvis, without involving any of the extremities, we think of cancer. And
tomorrow in part three, I'll take a look at the most recent scan to come to Rockford, the cardiology or heart scan.
President Carter is continuing his re-election campaign by proxy. Son Chip arrived in the Prairie State today for 2 days of stumping for his father. Today has been spent in the Chicago area, and tomorrow the younger Carter will make a westerly swing that will include Rockford, Rochelle, and DeKalb. Also tomorrow night, Vice President Mondale will drop in for a little campaigning. He will address a town meeting in Chicago. Challenger Edward Kennedy, meanwhile, has accepted an invitation to debate up in Madison, but only if President Carter accepts. The president, of course, has declined previous invitations, saying that he will not actively campaign until the American hostages are freed. Now, California Governor Jerry Brown has joined Kennedy in accepting, tentatively, the offer to debate. Two Republican congressional candidates in the 16th District are concerned about the scandalous activities uncovered in recent FBI sting investigations, and they're calling for action that would wipe out these activities in Congress. Steve Anderson says that congressmen who commit felonies should be thrown out of office, and he'd like to see a special prosecutor appointed to investigate such cases. Meanwhile, Dick Crosby says that limiting the term of office for representatives in Washington would lead to higher ethics displayed by congressmen. He also emphasizes voter registration, saying that the ballot box is the symbol of American democracy.
In the income tax evasion trial of William Scott today, the defense tried to weaken the prosecution's theory that Scott should have reported the salary that he paid to that was paid to his girlfriend. Under cross-examination, a witness from the IRS testified that there was no evidence that the girlfriend had written any checks to Scott during the time she was working for Chicago Stadium. Prosecutors say since she got the job at Scott's request and since she was never seen at work, her income really went to Scott. Governor Thompson wants President Carter to step into the middle of the Rock Island Railroad mess. Thompson wants the line to keep operating for an extra 60 to 90 days. Otherwise, freight shipments will end on February 15th and all services will stop March 2nd. If this happens, the governor warns commuters and businesses will be hit unduly hard. The Rock Island has been operating for the past 5 months under order of the Interstate Commerce Commission.
Well, the Kiwanis Club of Rockford is gearing up for its annual Pancake Day, which is the largest festival of its kind in the world. Kiwanis members held a luncheon to kick off ticket sales for the March 12th event. A colorful skit typified this year's theme, which is the Olympics. Last year, the Kiwanis Club raised a little more than $43,000 to help charities out in the area. And most of that sum came from the Pancake Spectacular. Kiwanians expect about 30,000 pancake eaters will help to make this year just as successful. And speaking of Olympics, of course, Jack, tonight is the night.
As a matter of fact, things are going on right now. The hockey competition is underway, but still, what's the story on the Summer Games? I'll have that, Jeff, and all the sports coming up after this.
See you living alone any longer. You have a daughter out west.
Is an old woman wanted anywhere?
She won't have room for me. Where will they put me? Four teenagers, all that rock and roll. I can't walk to help with anything.
Your hug.
Hi, everybody. I'm not surprised, but I'm awfully disappointed. The International Olympic Committee has just decided to keep the Summer Olympics in Moscow. The IOC voted 73-0 to reject President Carter's call for the games to be moved or canceled. Now the United States Olympic Committee has the ball in its own court. It will have to decide if the U.S. will boycott the Summer Games. Meanwhile, the 1980 Winter Olympics are underway in Lake Placid, and in hockey action today, Canada clobbered Holland 10-1, while the Czechs shut out Norway 11-0, and the United States is now playing Sweden. You can see highlights right here on 13 tonight, starting at 8:30. The rest of the Olympic events get started following tomorrow's opening ceremonies, and ABC has this Olympic preview.
In the slaloms, it's Ingemar Stenmark who will be golden through the gates. The Swede no longer races the others, but merely to set records now. U.S. chances depend on how well Phil Mayer responds from this crash here at Lake Placid a year ago when he fractured an ankle. Mayer's twin brother Steve also competes in the slaloms, but alpine skiing is ruled by Europeans. Innsbruck, 1976. An Austrian named Klammer flying to glory in the downhill that will live forever in the history of the Winter Olympics. But Franz Klammer will be absent when the downhillers race here in Lake Placid this week. Klammer lost his spot on the Austrian team, but many suggest he lost his confidence in the downhill because of a crash that crippled his brother 3 years ago. White Face Mountain would have been a challenge for Klammer, but even without him, Austria looms as a medal contender in the downhill, while Switzerland and Canada are the favorites. In Nordic skiing, it's the Europeans, although the Scandinavian countries get a piece of the action in the biathlon events and the cross country. America's Bill Koch, a silver medalist, Innsbruck 1976, may be even more determined on his own soil this time out. Jim Denny of Minnesota, America's jumper, the lone eagle flying off the 70-meter hill. Otherwise, it's the Germans and the Austrians. And when it comes to the high speed of the bobsled and the luge, the Germans also rule, but the Soviets will challenge this time. Willie Davenport, the U.S. hurdler of past summer games, a gold medalist at Mexico City in 1968, will now test his courage on the U.S. four-man bob team.
And next week, the figure skaters go to the ice in both the men's and women's competition. And for 22-year-old David Santee, who trains in Janesville, it will be his second Olympiad.
Olympics is never a routine performance. You know, it's one of the biggest thrills in my life. But the advantage that I have in being there before is that I know what to expect. And everything they say about the Olympics is true. It's just an awesome spectacle. Everything about it is so grandiose. You get the opening ceremonies are just, you know, incredible. And everything is so big that, you know, you kind of get lost a little bit. So I really am happy that I've had the experience of being there the first time, and I think it'll help me for this time.
Santee, who finished second in the U.S. Nationals, says he considers himself a dark horse to win a medal. Chicago Bulls head coach Jerry Sloan gets a vote of confidence. General manager Rod Thorne and managing partner Jonathan Kovler both say they want Sloan back next year despite the team's record of 19-38. Notre Dame enhanced its chances of getting an NCAA tournament bid by beating San Francisco last night. The Irish, who dropped out of the top 10 this week for the first time this season, got off to a great start. Tracy Jackson hit his first seven, that basket making it 21-8, Fighting Irish. Coach Digger Phelps got a strong effort from guard Bill Hanslick from Beloit. His nice touch inside here, and the Irish lead 47-33 at the half, up by 1 point by as much as 20. Both coaches watched the Dons roar back in the second half, cutting it to 6 on baskets like this by John Hegwood. But with 7 minutes to go, Hanslick helped the Irish pull away. First a steal, and then a pass to Kelly Trepuka, making it 67-59 Irish. And then at the other end, Hanslick breaks free for the dunk as the Irish rolled to a 78-66 win for their 17th win of the year against 4 losses. Bill Hanslick came out of Beloit Memorial High School. He's proving to be one of the best guards in the country.
Another example of local boy makes good.
You know it. And tonight at 8:30, the first night of Olympic coverage right here on 13.
Okay, thank you, Jack. We'll be back with more after this.
Even with snow still covering the fields, you're already planning how to be sure you'll get the most out of your corn crop. With dependable Sutan Plus herbicide with atrazine or Bladex, you can control weeds consistently, dependably, all season long. As you get ready for this season, plan now to use Sutan Plus with atrazine or Bladex. Dependable Sutan Plus for field-proven performance.
Commonwealth Edison and the Bank of America have signed a credit agreement committing up to $300 million for the financing of acquisition of nuclear fuel for ComEd. The Bank of America said the agreement is believed to be the largest ever arranged in the nation for an investment-owned utility.
That dispute between the Winnebago County Board and County Treasurer Doug Oran could end up costing all of us money. The county took Oran to court, claiming he had no right to contract for private computer services and won its case. It first appeared that the Burroughs Computer Company would be left holding the bag. But this morning, Burroughs filed suit for $100,000, naming Oran, Winnebago County, State's Attorney Dan Doyle, and Board Chairman Larry Ralston as co-plaintiffs. Burroughs charged them with deceptive business practices and breach of contract. On Wall Street today, prices changed direction 3 times in a wild roller coaster session. The Dow Jones Industrial Average began the day lower, sinking more than 4 points. It recovered at midday, dipped again, then roared on to the finish, closing up nearly 9.5 points. The market ended the day mixed. The declines outpaced advances by a small margin, and trading was active.
Delightful. Besan Fields, Hearts and Flowers for Valentine's, $15. Call or come see us at Besan Field, Alpine at Riverside.
It's tough to beat Centcor Performance, tough to beat dependability. Stay on top with a proven product, stay on top with Centcor quality.
When you see beans this clean, the odds are they're Syncor beans, because Syncor is used by more soybean growers than any other broadleaf herbicide. So stay on top with dependable, proven Syncor, wettable powder or liquid.
Stay on top with Syncor quality.
Ready, Western action with the Cartwright family, starring Lorne Green, Pernell Roberts, Dan Blocker, and Michael Landon, Friday, late night, following Charlie's Angels at 12:30 a.m. on Channel 13.
Hurry, Charlie, you're such a slowpoke.
I'm strong.
Don't forget to clean that up. You know how messy you are.
Michelle, I told you I was going to wash those pants. Sometimes you're so dense.
How children think about themselves is often determined by the labels you put on them.
That's a beautiful boat. You're sure good with your hands.
Okay, we're checking out the chances of some snow coming our way here.
Well, we'll probably get a light dusting of snow starting tomorrow and tomorrow night. But you realize, of course, that 4 years ago on this date, we were up to 56 degrees, which, you know, is a great way to start the bicentennial year.
Oh, I love it.
Tonight, we're not going to be that lucky, Linda. I don't know what to tell you. Partly cloudy with a low of around 5 degrees. Tomorrow, like I said, cloudy with a 40% chance of snow. High tomorrow afternoon around 25 degrees, low tomorrow night around 7 degrees with another 40% chance of snow. And looking ahead for Thursday, mostly sunny with a high of around 25 degrees.
That sounds nice.
As for Lake Placid, well, they're making new snow, so it doesn't matter.
They got a bunch.
No fresh stuff, though.
They got an inch.
And it's causing some problems on the downhill runs, I understand, as far as the skiers
are
concerned.
Is that right?
They could get like
clouds
up there.
You don't mix natural and unnatural snow.
Well, there's a lesson in there for all of us.
Really?
Don't mess around with Mommy Nature. That's one of my major rules I always follow.
What's up tonight in the Olympics now?
We're going to find out how the U.S. hockey team did. They're playing Sweden right now. We'll have highlights and part of our coverage tonight. Also, we'll look at some of the big events coming up, and that's from 8:30 to 10 right here on 13. And then tomorrow, one of the big events, the luge. So we've talked about before, Debbie Genovese from Rockford will show how good she is.
She'll be the first Rockfordian now
we
can watch.
We only have two.
Okay.
Along with David Santee, who trains in Janesville, who will skate next week in the figure skating.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. That's it for now. Join us at 10 for more Dateline 13 news, and have a pleasant evening. Good night.
WREX-TV, Rockford, Illinois.
Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday.